What's going on, guys? My name is Lionheart. Welcome back to the den, and today I am joined with my good friend and brother Jesse Tiff. How you doing?
What's good? I'm here. And I'm ready. Let's do it,
dude. I am spiritually ready, and today we're going to be tackling the time-honored traditional comparison. Two giants on one side facing each other. We have Paladins, the Hi-rez Studios class-based shooter, whatever the fuck, MOBA, I don't know, versus Overwatch, the game that can do no wrong if you are on Reddit. The game that is flawless if you are on Reddit. And if you say anything wrong about Overwatch, you are wrong.
And anything that came before it or after it is a copy of Overwatch.
Yes, even if it came before it. Team Fortress 2 confirmed Overwatch clone, you heard it here first.
Overwatch was in production.
Obviously, guys, we're not here to debate whether Paladins is a rip of Overwatch. We don't think so. There's enough facts out there debunking that. If you're one of those people, just go. There are other videos for you.
Just stop, man. Just stop.
It's time to stop. Yes. We're gonna debate Paladins as its own standalone game, free of bias. We're gonna do the same thing for Overwatch. And we're just gonna see what the games have going for them in our opinion, and then we're gonna come to a conclusion of which game we think is better, and there's a very likelihood that we might say both are good. We don't know. So we're gonna start off with Paladins here. So, Jess, what is your initial thoughts of Paladins?
I love Paladins. I think it's worth saying that I played Overwatch first, and I played a lot of Overwatch first, and then I stopped playing Overwatch altogether, and then I started to play Paladins after that, and then I was like, okay, I'm really liking this. So for me, Paladins is a lot different than Overwatch, and I really enjoy it. I think the balance is really good, and the gameplay is nice and fun and makes me come back.
Yes, so same thing for me. Of course, Overwatch did come out for most people first, unless you got into the Paladins closed alphas, which I did not. So my first exposure was Overwatch as well, and I love Overwatch. I still play Overwatch. Obviously, my last couple of videos have been on Overwatch, but I got really bored and decided to pick up Paladins because I didn't really think much of it when it first came out and decided to give it a try.
Yeah,
and I have to admit, it really surprised me at what it had to offer. I thought it was going to be a really shallow game, but it proved to have a lot of depth to it. So a lot of people seem unclear about what Paladins does and what Paladin brings to the table. So I think we're going to take a minute here and just break down a little bit about what makes Paladins really good. Jess, you want to take that away?
Yeah, sure. It's definitely more MOBA-y if you played any MOBAs. I know a lot of people who played Overwatch came from a first-person shooter background, and not as many people came from a MOBA background. So if you've played any MOBAs, you played Paragon, you played League of Legends, Paladins is a lot more MOBA-y. There's a item market, there's decks to build for each hero, which I think adds some nice depth for me because in Overwatch, it can be very dull. You pick a character, you go with that character, all the characters are unlocked, you can play anything, which is a nice advantage. But in Paladins, there's more of a progression system. You can unlock cards that do different things for your heroes, which is it's a nice touch. I like it that way.
Yeah, I think that's the big thing that separates the two. So you have two predominantly hero-based shooters with MOBA elements. Where Overwatch leans more towards a first-person shooter, you have Paladins, which leans a lot more towards a MOBA. And I think the deck system is something that adds a lot of replayability, because now you don't have heroes that are just played one way, right? You can constantly innovate and create new decks and keep just finding new ways to play that hero, and sometimes more effective ways. And, you know, that obviously has its own drawbacks, right? Like, there could be decks that come out that are way better than anything you come up with, and now suddenly you have to play that one deck, right? And maybe it costs a little bit too much for you to unlock that deck. So it's just kind of, there's a trade-off there, but I think the deck system all in all is really good.
Yeah, I think it also makes a nice incentive to put in the hours too, because it's a free-to-play game and it has a standard free-to-play model where you have to unlock heroes and you can grind to get essence to unlock decks and cards. And it's a nice incentive to play more because you know you're grinding to get that card that you want. You're grinding to get enough essence to unlock the next hero.
Yeah. And there is a $20 Founders Pack for this game. Mm-hmm. And to be quite honest, I went ahead and picked it up because I thought there was enough here for me to chew on to play a good amount of hours into it. So far, I've put like maybe 30 hours into the game and I've been enjoying it. So the $30 Founders Pack gives you a lot. You get a lot of gold and essence to buy cards. You get all heroes and all future heroes. There's a lot of value there because there's typically a lot of grinding involved when you're dealing with grinding free-to-plays.
The $20 Founders Pack is a nice way to get out of the free-to-play or pay-to-win model. That, and it's definitely there, just like any other free-to-play shooter. Some of the best heroes are behind a paywall, and that's how it is. But with that being said, right out the gate, you can purchase a hero. Right, you have enough gold right out the gate to buy a hero. So if you see that Androxus or you see Maeve, maybe you want to pick up Maeve, you can get one right out the box, which is a nice little token.
Yeah, and plus, once you get past the first initial couple of level ups on your profile, you unlock the weekly quests. I mean, yeah. I was finding that within my first couple hours, like after 3 or 4 hours of play, trying to grind my characters up, I had enough gold to buy a hero. So the grind's not insane, and you definitely could go just straight on as free to play and not have to spend any money in this game.
Yeah.
Just personally, I decided to put down the money because I wanted to support the game, and I was too lazy.
I think it's worth it, too.
Yeah, because now you don't have to worry about buying new heroes, and they plan
yeah,
on
and you
a
have
ton
the
of heroes.
All future heroes as well, which is a,
yeah, that's
you know,
a really
nice
good
touch.
Value.
You're not stuck behind a paywall, even though you paid for the original Founders Pack.
Yeah, I guess that's another thing to touch on. I don't know how many heroes are currently in Paladins, but I believe it does rival Overwatch. 1 second.
Yeah, I think it's a little bit short Overwatch, but they're planning on releasing 17 heroes this year.
Yeah, so they're decking out this game with a lot of new heroes. Here, real quick, I'm just pulling up how many heroes are currently in the game. You got 6, 12, 18. And you have 23 heroes currently. They just added their 23rd this week. Overwatch has 24 heroes, and Overwatch has been out full launch longer. This game has been in beta. So
yes, and new characters in Overwatch are very slow to come.
Yes, and typically, they once they get out, they don't even get onto the main game. They get announced and put onto the PTR, but that's kind of it's a little separate. So
I think it's worth saying too that the one of the things that makes Paladins different is the fact that you can't change your hero.
How do you mean? Oh yeah, like in game. Yeah, so I was
like
gonna,
as soon as you're in a game, you're locked in. It's a MOBA, you know. You're not. You can't just switch out. You like say you want to in Overwatch, you go okay, I'll be Widowmaker for Arkenwald or whatever, or King's Row. You're like, I'm on defense, I'll be Widowmaker for a little bit, and then I'll switch back onto a real DPS. That's not an option in Paladins. It's very more team comps are very important in Paladins because you cannot change your hero.
Yeah, so we're going to go ahead and jump into the gameplay now. So that is the one stark difference between the two right away, is that when you jump into the gameplay, you're very, very much in a MOBA territory. There's a hero draft at the beginning of the game. You pick your heroes. Then you get into the game, you pick your cards and your loadout, and you're done. If you pick a hero and you're not doing well as a hero, you are stuck as that hero the whole game. It's really unforgiving. So you have to kind of look at your picks very carefully and kind of be aware of what other people are picking in terms of the current meta and kind of be wary of it. You don't want to go with a really super off pick because you think you're going to do well with it because you might punish your whole team for that. You know, in the same token, if you're not a good DPS and you pick up an attack character and you just totally bomb it for your whole team now, you are you're dead weight, right? So you have to be very careful with your picks.
That's the nice part about the item market is because there's the counters are built into the item market. Instead of being able to change a hero, you can counter whatever they're doing with one of your cards that you buy.
Yeah. So either way, you have cards and loadouts. But once you get into the game, you have upgrades you can purchase while in game. It's a bit hard to explain. I'm going to have some footage running in the background to show it. So like when you spawn into a game, you pick your legendary, which is like your main perk card. That's what you're going to base your card loadout off of, is your legendary pick. So you pick your legendary, you pick your loadout, and then you have what are called crystals to spend during the pregame. You can spend crystals on specific upgrades like reload speed. You could pick, do more damage to shields. You can pick like getting health regen on hits or stuff like that. You could get faster ultimate. Like a ton of these options that you can really kind of key in. And the whole point of those is to really hard counter your enemy picks. So let's say the enemy team is running like a heavy shielded character like Torvald. Then what you're going to do on your side is pick the extra shield damage to try and melt through that shield faster. So there's a lot of interplay there with picking your perk ups after your loadout during the game.
Yeah. Yeah, and then it's split into four categories. So like let's say you want to do like they have a Torvald, so you pick Wrecker so you can do more damage to shield, but then you can't have Cauterize, which is where you hit somebody and they can't heal. So there's a lot of like different options to go with, but each has a trade-off. You can't just stack your deck to, card counter everybody.
Yeah, so I can't have anti-heal, shield damage, and reload speed all on the same kit. Now I have to choose one, right? So there's a lot of interplay there, and sometimes you can make the bad pick and be, you know, down in a fight because of it. So it's really punishing.
Yeah, I think it's worth... Go ahead.
It's really punishing for people that aren't really paying attention to the other team in terms of their picks.
Right. Right. And I think it's worth mentioning that the fact that there's three legendaries on every hero.
Yep.
And those three legendaries, depending on which one you pick, really change the whole gameplay of your hero. Whereas in Overwatch, the hero does what your hero does, you know. There's no way to, you know, add reload speed or add, you know, an extra hook on your Widowmaker or whatever, you know. Like, whereas in Paladins with Maeve, you could have like the Battle Runner where you can reset your pounce right away after a kill, which is, I mean, it completely changes the way your hero plays.
Yeah, or even just sticking to Maeve there, who's kind of like this assassin type character with throwing knives and stuff. Another one of her legendary cards lets her triple jump. And that can completely change how she plays, because now she's a lot more vertical, right? I think one of my favorite examples is using Drogos, who a lot of people that hate on Paladins call the Mutant Pharah, because he has a rocket launcher. But his three legendaries are all insanely good and insanely change how he plays. So he has one that increases his direct rocket damage, one that increases the knockback off of one of his abilities, and the other that boosts his jets. All three of them are really good, and you're going to base three different really good decks off of each of those legendary cards. You just have to kind of choose it based off what your preference is.
Yeah.
So, kind of sticking more to a little bit of the gameplay. It is primarily very similar in terms of game modes to Overwatch, where a lot of it's payload-based. The most common game mode is objective, where you have to capture a King of the Hill-style point, and that will spawn a payload. They have to push the payload into the enemy team spawn. So kind of like King of the Hill with a payload, it's pretty cool. It's my favorite game mode. The straight up payload game modes are a little slower, a little longer, but this one's really fast paced and is, I think, the preferred competitive mode for most people.
Yeah.
Speaking of competitive, Paladins does have a very active esports scene. In fact, just today when we're recording this, they were having a major qualifier for a big LAN tournament they were doing. So the esports scene is there, and it's actually pretty exciting to watch. Compared to Overwatch, they're both pretty healthy. They're both really fast paced compared to regular play, though. God, you watch competitive Overwatch and competitive Paladins, they are moving so damn fast, it's insane.
Yeah, no, and the announcers they have are very popular community YouTubers who have a Paladins YouTube channel, which I think is a nice touch to pull the your announcers out of the community. I think that's a really good
idea. Yeah, and Overwatch has kind of done similar as well. You know, one of my favorite casters being Stir, one of my favorite YouTubers from Team Fortress 2. Love you, Stir. You're the best. So generally, overall gameplay in Paladins, in my opinion, is faster. The TTK is faster. The movement is faster. Paladins seems to have a bigger focus on comboing abilities together instead of just using individual abilities for individual purposes compared to Overwatch. I don't know how you feel about that.
Stay again, I'm sorry.
I was saying that the abilities in Paladins generally are meant to be comboed together instead of just used separately. I feel that's one thing Overwatch has with certain characters, but definitely not with all of them. Like, obviously, Genji, you have to use this whole kit to make it work. But for a lot of characters, it's just using kit individually and making individual plays based off your abilities.
Well, that's a good way to talk about this, because Maeve was heavily overpowered and they nerfed her. And the problem with her nerf is because her kit is used all together and comboed together, and they only nerfed a couple of things about her kit, she's still incredibly really strong.
Yeah.
You know, and that's one of the, that kind of puts into what you're saying, whereas you need to use all of your abilities together in Paladins, and that's kind of like a, I like that. I like having, it's very MOBA-y to combo all your moves together and take out somebody pretty quick.
And it's weird because while you're really ability reliant in this game, the skirmishing, just straight up gunfire, like your individual weapons are still really strong. Like, if you're playing Knessa, who is a lot like Widowmaker from Overwatch, you don't really have to use much of your abilities. You can just sit there and dome headshots the entire time. But you have a really good kit that can help make that easier. So if you can use that in tandem, you can just fucking shred teams, right?
Her really abilities are really good. You know, like, you have those two oppressor mines you throw in different spots. It slows the super fast people down.
Oh, man, it's so bad.
Them in
so
the dome. It's such a good combo.
I fucking hate those oppressor mines. They're really good, though. They're so annoying to find. But it feels like in Overwatch, after I've played so much of it, that there's so little like true skirmishes. A lot of it is like kind of just poking at each other until you get ultimates and then pushing with ultimates, right? I feel like Paladins, there's a lot more general skirmish, which I find to be more enjoyable in general.
More gunplay, for sure. A lot more gunplay.
And all the characters in Paladins are really diverse. There isn't a single character in Paladins that feels similar to another. The same thing can be said for Overwatch as well, so that's really good.
Yeah, I agree.
So, I mean, those are my general thoughts on Paladins. We actually haven't been able to get into ranked, because getting into ranked is actually really hard in this game.
Yeah, I almost wish there was a way to just pay around it, to be honest, because it is 12 different heroes to level 4, and man, that is just quite a grind.
Yeah, it's quite a grind, but in a way I'm kind of glad of it, because it's
smart to do it that way.
Yeah, it puts a noob filter on ranked.
It's a noob filter, yeah.
Yeah, which I agree with. That means that ranked is going to be super competitive once we get around to it. It's going to be a fun thing to delve into for sure. And frankly, the casual modes are still insanely competitive. Like, I really enjoy this game. This game is super fun.
Yeah, I love the casual. I think the gunplay is really fun. I think it's another thing is to say that until level 5, you are playing against co-op versus AI. I don't think that's well defined in the game. I think you have to figure it out on your own. Because I thought that I was playing co-op versus AI the whole time, and I stopped at level 4, stopped playing Paladins altogether, because I was annoyed that I couldn't play PvP until I got 12 heroes to rank 4. But it turns out you're just co-op versus AI until you're level 5.
Yeah, so, and it should be said that getting to rank 5 is actually pretty easy for the most part.
A couple hours
at the very most. And if you come from Overwatch, maybe you come from a heavy shooter background, frankly, you can just pick a DPS character and shred all the bots, to be honest.
Yeah, if you just get a lot of kills, you get a lot of XP.
I think my first couple hours, I was posting 40 plus elim games, just shredding bots, and I thought that I was playing all these nerds who were just really bad, so I felt really good about myself. It was pretty great.
Yeah.
I get to play the game every time, dude. I'm the fucking greatest.
That's another thing. I think it's easier to get higher elim games in Paladins than it is in Overwatch. I feel like I see way more 40 to 50 elim games from myself in Paladins than I do Overwatch. I don't know if that's due to pace or due to gameplay.
I think it's a lot of it has to do with the general TTK, because there's a lot more burst damage in Paladins. Overwatch,
right,
a lot of it
can take you down.
Yeah,
really fast.
Overwatch has a lot of kind of poke and team fights and alt combos. Yeah. So generally speaking, you're not going to have as many elims in Overwatch compared to Paladins. Yeah. That's just a straight up pacing thing, really.
Yeah, it's definitely easier to dominate as well in Paladins solo than it is in Overwatch.
I think that's...
In Overwatch, you need to be duo, triple Q, at least 4-stack, 5-stack, because it's just too easy to get run over by a team.
Yeah, I think that's a big thing that we should stress here, is that Paladins is going to appeal a lot more to people that like to play solo or like to be able to carry teams compared to Overwatch. Overwatch is definitely a lot more like team focused at the casual and like non-esports level.
Yeah.
Paladins, you can get away with a lot if you're really good as an individual player. Yes. Overwatch, you're pretty much stonewalled if you're an insane player with a bad team. So I kind of like that, though, because frankly, I don't play with 4 or 5 stacks all the time. Very rarely, in fact.
Like, I don't think it's anywhere near the average. Where I think 95% of people that play these kind of games are playing solo.
Yeah. I mean, I do see
there's
quite
no
a few.
Way that the majority of the, or at least 60-40 or 70-30, because there's just not that many people playing together.
Yeah, I definitely noticed the key times are a lot longer when you're in 6-stack in Overwatch for sure.
Right.
So Overwatch, it's very, very what's the word?
Team based.
Harsh.
Team-based.
Harsh on people who play solo.
Oh yeah, no, for sure.
So those are our general thoughts on Paladins. I think it's I think it's a really good game, but I think there's a lot to digest there. Kind of switching gears, and we're gonna look at Overwatch now. And Overwatch is a game I hold very near and dear to my heart, because when it came out, I was at a point when I was super burnt out on Counter-Strike. I had played a ton of Team Fortress 2. Team Fortress 2 being one of my favorite games of all time. And I saw Overwatch come out, and I was just like, oh, thank God, Blizzard coming in to save the day like they always do with every game genre. Yes!
Right. Yeah.
And frankly, I wasn't disappointed. Overwatch is fantastic.
It's a great game.
I think they really hit every nail on the head well too great in every respect. Yeah. The game runs smooth, the hit reg is good, the model with the price in the game versus what you get is great. All the heroes are available right away. The heroes are good. The ranked is fun, if not frustrating, but the ranked is fun. There's
all the skins.
The maps are great. The skins are great. It's really hard to say anything bad about Overwatch. No. But it's definitely not free of issues.
No, I think the gameplay in Overwatch is incredible. I think the heroes are great. I can't complain about anything except for I got bored of the game because it's just it's harsh on solo players, and I play predominantly solo. I came from console where I was playing console a lot, and then I made a PC and started playing on PC. I liked it better on PC, but it's still the same issue. Playing solo sucks, especially not getting good team comps. And then I just never found a hero that I love to play. Like, I like to play Widowmaker, but she just gets shit on by everybody else in the game. You're just like, don't play Widow. And you're just like, holy shit, dude, let me live. And I think there's a lot of that in Overwatch where people want to play off-meta heroes. And it's such a harsh community that they're just like shitting all over.
Yeah, this game is like the meta is the Bible. And dude, if you don't stick to the Bible, we're going to kick you out of the church. So
yeah.
I think a lot of Overwatch's problems comes from how dead stuck a lot of people are on the meta. And that's not necessarily their fault. They want to win, and I can understand that. But a lot of tournaments, if you watch a lot of the tournament play in Overwatch, they're sticking to the meta, but they also pick a lot of off-meta picks to try and upset the meta. Like at MLG Vegas. At MLG Vegas, we saw people running Torb and Symmetra and Sombra and Pharah, all to great effect. But heaven forbid I decide to pick fucking McCree over Soldier 76 in rank. No, you are wrong. Get off that character right the fuck now. You know?
I think people underestimate how strong all the characters are. I think the balance is pretty good in Overwatch, where you could pretty much win with anything as long as you keep a good team comp where you have a couple of tanks, a couple of healers, a couple of DPS. So,
dude,
it's unfortunate that the community is so harsh about it.
Yeah. Like, I straight up stopped playing during Season 3 of Ranked in Overwatch because heaven forbid someone decides to not play triple or quad tank in the meta. The triple tank, quad tank meta for me was abysmal. It was so slow. It was so cheesy. And pretty much
so
it just came...
Overwatch is slow in general, too.
Yeah, but you mean even slower by making everyone tanks and it coming down to two ult fights a game. Like, that's just not fun, right? And you could
super annoying.
The annoying part was is that Sombra had been out at that point, and a lot of people wrote Sombra off, but Sombra proved to be a direct counter to the triple tank meta, but no one was allowed to play here because if you played Sombra, you were throwing, you know?
Yeah, you're throwing. So, fucking God.
A lot of Overwatch's problem is definitely holding too strong to the meta, and that's why I think the changes that they're currently making are good, because they're trying to disrupt that meta and keep things changing. Of course, now we're into Season 4, we're seeing a lot more 2 DPS, 2 tank, 2 healers, which is good. It makes things more diverse. I think as long as we keep away from that triple tank,
that's so bad. Well, the problem is now is we're gonna, and you see it from all a bunch of YouTubers are talking about it, is it's going to be fucking Barrier Watch, where it's nothing but barriers everywhere with Reinhardt and Orisa. So I don't know how that meta is going to shake out. I'm going to reserve opinion until it's out. And we see how it does in ranked and competitive and stuff. So,
the
double barriers is going to be really rough, to be honest, because it's already hard enough to take down Reinhardt barrier, and then there's immediately up another barrier. And the fact that Orisa has a short cooldown on that barrier, by the time you blow it up, she can put another one up.
That's why I'm calling it right now, dude. Sombra is going to be key once Orisa comes out. Being able to shut down barriers all day.
Well, I know they're trying to make Zenyatta be a barrier counter by letting you put your Discord orb through barriers now.
They already reverted that change.
They already took it back.
Yep.
I thought they just did that on the PTR, no?
Yeah, they put it out for a couple days, and they're like, okay, we're going to dial it back a little bit. And then they might do more buffs or nerfs if needed. So they're not really too set in stone on the changes in the PTR right now.
We'll see how Barrier Watch turns out. I think it's going to be a rough meta, though.
Yeah, dude. So, I mean, you guys should be able to tell from the fact that most of our discussion about Overwatch went straight into, like, the meta and the community versus the game itself, because Overwatch as a game, it's hard to fault it. The game runs well.
It's an incredible game. I'm not going to sit here and say it's a bad game. I'm just saying I get sick of playing it because you want to play different heroes, and even in just quick play, you get shit on for playing different heroes. Like, can you switch? And do I want to win my fucking quick play game? And just like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. I think definitely Overwatch is, it's weird because it's so competitive, but also it feels a bit casual, right?
Yeah.
Like, the gameplay does feel casual. Like, I go from Paladins to Overwatch. In Paladins, there's so much interplay going on with your cards and your loadout and the abilities, and you have to do everything at once, your movement and all that. Overwatch, it's kind of just like you just sit behind Reinhardt as a Soldier 76 and just spam, and then a lot of the complexity comes from team comp and strategy as opposed to individual play and hero ability and all that. So I think it just, it makes the game feel simpler and not necessarily in a good way, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think one of the things that Paladins does better, and I think this is a controversial thing that I'm about to say, but I'm going to say it anyways, I think regenerative health is better in Paladins because it speeds up the game. You don't have to go hunting for health packs if you're hurt.
Yeah.
You can just step out of the battle for a second and then hop back in. And I know that that sucks because you put all that damage into Reinhardt and now he's going to regen his health. But in Paladins, it's a much faster paced game than Overwatch.
Yeah, frankly, if you had a Reinhardt, then there's a Reinhardt style character in Overwatch. He dies very fast. It's not like, God, man, I think Paladins really hits the nail on the head in terms of pacing, honestly.
Yeah, the pace is really good.
I think because I come from Team Fortress 2, Team Fortress 2 and Paladins have a lot similar in terms of how it plays and pacing and all that. It's a lot more up my alley. And it feels like I'm playing Team Fortress 2 from the old days, just kind of different and made better, in my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah, I love Paladins. I love Overwatch, too. And I always come back when there's a new hero or a new season comes out. I'll play some ranked. And so Overwatch is a good time. I just think that it sucks that Paladins came out and it got all this hate. And there's so many people that are just looking at Paladins and going, I'll never play it because it's Overwatch. It's completely different than Overwatch. I hope this video showed you that it's different than Overwatch, and it'll at least give it a try. It's a short download it on your PC and give it a shot.
And I have to be honest, like, I was in that group, right?
Yeah,
I really liked Overwatch. I saw Paladins come out, I saw what other people were saying, and I just kind of took that at face value and wrote it off. A lot of that had to do with the fact that I thought Smite was a pile of hot garbage, which it is. So I didn't think that the guys who developed Smite could actually do something better than Smite.
Yeah.
But, you know, eventually I got bored enough with everything else. I was like, you know, fuck it, I'm going to try it. And I'm really glad I did, because I think I found something that really, really speaks to me and wants me to play more of it.
Same.
So I think we're kind of to a head here with this video. I think we both agree that they're both incredible games. But I do think Paladins has an edge in terms of replayability over Overwatch.
Yeah, I totally agree with that.
Yeah. I feel like Paladins,
especially for solo players.
Like it's weird to compare it to Counter-Strike, because you would think Counter-Strike is so team-based. Why would you solo in Counter-Strike? But I soloed my way through 3 years of Counter-Strike and never really got bored of it. You know?
No, Counter-Strike's a great time solo.
Yeah. So I get a lot of those vibes from Paladins, where just it feels like I want to grind and put more hours into it. Where Overwatch, I'll pick it up, I'll play it for a couple hours, and then get bored and go do something else.
Yeah, I
think we both agree Overwatch is fantastic. We just both think that Paladins has really something amazing to offer here, and you guys should definitely check it out.
Definitely.
Alright guys, so this has been Paladins versus Overwatch. You guys can find Jesse Tiv in the description box below on his two YouTube channels and his Twitter. If you want to check out Paladins, I'll leave a link below. Make sure you guys leave that like, hit that subscribe button, keep here in the den for more videos. My name has been Lionhearts, and we will see you next time.
Later.